One of the most common ways to make sure that an application is up and running and working well is by keeping an eye on its component processes and checking their resource utilization. With Boundary, we have a couple of plugins for keeping an eye on the memory usage and CPU of given processes. And in this video, I'll show you how to set up and configure the CPU memory plugin. Now, first of all, I have a meter installed, which is sending back metrics to my dashboard, as you can see. And that's on the machine that I want to keep an eye on the processes of. And then I just need to go and add the plugin. So I go to Settings and Plugins. Here's all of the plugins I have in my account right now. And I can click Get Plugins to go and add some more. This is the list of currently available plugins. And the one that I need for this video is Process Memory. That's going to add the metric to my account and any dashboards or anything else that comes with it, and it will then take me through to the meters menu so that I can go and deploy this plugin somewhere and use it. So there we've added the mem process metric to my account, so I'll click on OK. This takes me through to my list of active meters. I currently only have one, so I'll deploy down to there. I'll choose it from the list. I want to deploy the process memory. Now the prerequisite screen is showing me that this plugin currently only supports Linux and does require a Node.js runtime. Luckily, I have Node.js installed on this machine already. If I didn't, I could click on this link, and we've got a nice knowledge base article to show you how to do that for your version of Linux. There's an explanation of all of the fields here, and I'll walk through them in the next screen with you. So I can add multiple processes to this, so I could have one meter and one plugin monitor multiple processes if needed. I'm only going to do one though, and I'm going to do a very, very literal example. So I give it a source, which is really just an identifier for me that will show up in my dashboards, and I'm going to call it Firefox, because I'm going to have it look for a process that's literally named Firefox. This is actually an Ubuntu desktop machine. Now this can also take a regex form if I wanted it to, process name. I could also do the process path, and I can do any combination of these if I want to, or the process's current working directory all in regular expression form. And then I have this reconcile option down here as well. This means if it finds more than one process that matches all of the above criteria, which one should it report on? So you have the option of just take the first match, you can take the parent, or you can take the longest running of the processes that it finds, and I'm just going to go with first match. So now if I click on OK and hit save, this will take me through to the console output from my meter, which will show it's installing the plugin for us. And then I can see plugin process memory has been started, so data collection has begun. So then I can jump back into my default dashboard. Because this is a very simple plugin, it doesn't have a dashboard of its own, so I can just go and add it to any dashboard I like. So I'm going to click on edit here. Here's the list of all the metrics I have installed in my account, and I've just added memprocess, so we'll take that and we'll drag it over here. And when I click on save, I should be able to see the memory usage of my Firefox process on my machine. And there we go. So that's how you can keep an eye on memory of a given process on a machine, and you can pair this up with the CPU process plugin as well to keep an eye on all of the resource usage of your critical processes on your servers.